Alright guys, so we're back for another Dokkan Battle video. So today we're going to go ahead and take a look at the STR Super Buu and all of the different forms he has. Courtesy of the private server, we are able to show all of Buu's transformations on the exact same team here. Now, as you guys know, this guy right here, Super Buu, is coming tonight on Global Dokkan. He's a pretty strong unit, right? Like, I'm not gonna say he's bad or anything. He's pretty good. After five turns, he'll transform into either Ultimate Gohan Buu, Gotenks Buu, or Piccolo Buu. Really, this video is gonna be about which of those transformations I feel is the best. I have used this Buu quite a bit. You guys may be familiar with the challenge I was doing this weekend, where I was using a full Buu team to try and take down the Majin Buu arc stage of Category Super Battle Road, where it really showed the strength of it. Throughout the course of the video, I want to try and prove the point that Buu Piccolo right here is, in fact, the best of all the transformations. The reason for this, as you guys know, Majin Buu units are notorious for not having key links, right? Well, this Buu right here is different in that he gives all allies 3 key and 30% defense on top of giving himself 100% attack and defense and recovering 15% HP at the start of turn. So Buu Piccolo is tremendous. Now, that's not to say anything light of the other transformations, you know, like Buu Gotenks, his passive, he recovers 8% HP at the start of turn, he gets 120% attack and 100% defense, and then he gets an additional 30% attack when the enemy is in the attack down status. So of course, you know, Buu Gotenks here is a very powerful unit in his own right, and then also Ultimate Gohan Buu, he recovers 10% HP at the start of turn, and then he also gives himself 120% attack and defense. So as you can see, they all kind of have pluses and minuses. They're all pretty good. Like, once they transform, all three of the transformations are quite good. But what you're going to find, I feel, most of the time, is that the Buu Piccolo would be the best of the three. The only issue with this is you're rarely ever going to see the transformation into Buu Piccolo. The reason for that is because the transformation requirements for Buu Gohan after 5 turns, between 80% to 100% health, that's what you're going to get most of the time. After 5 turns, between 50% and 79%, you will get Buu Gotenks. And then after 5 turns, under 49% HP, you would get Buu Piccolo. So most of the time, Buu Ultimate Gohan is going to be the Buu unit that you are going to be getting. You're definitely not going to be seeing Buu Piccolo very often, but when he does come out, he definitely will be the strongest of all of them, right? Especially, it has been made very evident when I've been, you know, going on, you know, in Super Battle Road. Now, all of these Buu units do generally struggle for ki. The STR Super Buu, all of his different forms, they all have Fear and Faith. So they do actually link up very well with each other. Now, this actually could come into play, let's say, just based upon the way the battle goes. You get a Buu Gotenks transformation, and you also get a Buu Ultimate Gohan transformation. They themselves will, of course, both link up having Fear and Faith, so that could be useful, right? Like, you know, when I try and do that all Majin Buu team challenge in Super Battle Road, that could be something that I'm really trying to sort of make happen, right? Would be having, you know, some of these Buus actually linked up next to each other. But, you know, obviously a lot of the time it's very difficult to sort of make that happen. Now, this is a this is kind of an overkill rotation right here, having two different support units, basically. Well, you know, Kid Buu, obviously, you guys know he does give the 50% attack and defense plus 2 ki. And then, you know, we got Buu Piccolo giving ki, and we also have Buu Ultimate Gohan. Let's go ahead and get a super attack from Buu Ultimate Gohan. He definitely will not hit as hard as Buu Ultimate Gohan. We're going to get a super attack first from Buu Piccolo because Buu Ultimate Gohan will hit a lot harder. Buu Piccolo greatly raises defense on super attacks. That will help him be able to tank a little bit more. But then Buu Ultimate Gohan, he actually, I believe, he greatly raises attack and defense for one turn. So he's able to get a nice little attack and defensive buff from his super attack, which is very, very helpful. All right, so we're going to get a second super attack here from our boy Boo Piccolo. As you guys can see, you know, he's just a shade under a 2 million attack set right here. Here we'll see Boo Ultimate Gohan, who without a doubt, yeah, up to what, 2.33 million that was. He is definitely able to hit a bit harder, but I think that three key that Boo Piccolo gives, it's just very, very important to sort of making the team sort of run as well as you would like, right? Now, here's the thing. In an ideal world, you would actually be able to get Boo Piccolo all the time. Like, dude, if Super Boo himself, if he gave, like, the three key that Boo Piccolo does in his sort of base transformation right here, that would be unbelievable. It would be so good if he would be able to do that, because the enhanced transformation team, or I believe, what is it called on Global? It's boosted transformation is the category name, has many very powerful units on it, right? You have units such as Blue Gogeta, UI Goku, Evolution Blue Vegeta. You know, you have the Int Goku Black. You got the Transforming Frieza, the Transforming Goku. All of these units are present on the team. All mid-battle transformation units outside of the fusions, so LR Vegito and LR Gogeta, and then outside of Turles, because his is more of a power buff rather than an actual transformation. They are not in the category, right? But outside of that, all the rest are. Now, some of them do link very well. You know, UI Goku and Evolution Blue Vegeta are incredible linking partners. You guys know that. They're able to, you know, work in unison very good. Broly and Gogeta actually do work kind of good together. Blue Gogeta and the full power Super Saiyan Broly. So, like, there's a lot of different combinations, rotations you can make that can sort of get the job done, right? But, you know, it still does leave a lot to be desired, because the transforming Boo, you know, just in a sort of base Super Boo form, he's only got shocking speed. Now, that does work well with, say, full power Broly. You know, they'll both have shocking speed. You know, they'll have, you know, Fierce Battle, which obviously when, you know, one of the most common links among, like, Dokkan Fest exclusives and stuff like that. But Boo just doesn't really work the best, right? And, you know, Ki could definitely become an issue in the right situation. But if that Boo had that three Ki the whole time, there would be no issues. It would just be smooth sailing all the time. You could build the team however you want. You know, the enhanced transformation or booster transformation category has pretty much all the forms of Majin Buu, all the forms of Frieza, all the forms of Cell. It is a very large category, one that will be, you know, it's going to be easy to build teams with. One other negative, however, about the team is that Super Buu leaders are impossible to find. When trying to run Super Buu on Super Battle Road, you know, until I made a tweet with my friend code and asked people to add me, it was taking me 15 to 20 minutes to find a Super Boo friend. Like, they just weren't around. No one on JP uses SCR Super Boo. I should also add that I have not seen very many EGL metal coolers either. So here we go. Here, you know, is one of the transformations. This is what we would see. Our health is, of course, at pretty much full. So he transforms into the Boo Ultimate Gohan. Now, this team we're rocking right here is actually, like, busted beyond belief. It's, like, too strong to actually be run, right? Because by having all these different forms of Boo, they're all healing, right? What, this guy heals 10, this guy heals 8%, this guy's healing 15%, this guy's healing 10%. Like, every single unit we have is healing a monstrous amount of HP. So it's going to be virtually, like, impossible to actually take damage. That's the thing about these transforming units is, you know, maybe a lot of times they are underwhelming, right? You know, in various different situations. But when you get a situation like this, where you can run, like, a full Gogeta team, or the full transforming Goku team, or the full Boo team, you know, we have this insanity, this absurdity, where these units, like, they're just too strong to be used together, right? All of them healing at the same time just creates a invincible team that just cannot be touched. Like, you know, here, you know, this Golden Frieza is one of the strongest Dokkan Fest bosses out right now. And, like, he super attacked. It did nothing to our health. And then on the next turn, we're going to be completely healed all the way back to full from having all these different Boos who are going to be able to use their transformations, right? One other thing I should add about the Gotenks Boo right here. He does gain over in a flash when he comes out. So if you're using the physical Gotenks Buu, who's a reasonably solid unit, they will share over in a flash, which can work pretty well with each other, right? But of course, you know, I don't know. A lot of times, I find myself not having fun running a lot of the Buu units just because they end up just, like, not being able to super attack. You know, when I'm running teams, I value consistency. And consistency is usually one thing that Buu teams will not guarantee you. Having a lot of these Buu units, they are not consistent options, which is a shame. So, here, I'm pretty sure we're going to go ahead and finish out the video and the rotation right here with all of these Boos. Again, this guy is coming out tonight on Global. I do strongly encourage you guys not to summon for him. You know, he's a fine unit, sure, but wait until he comes back as a secondary unit featured on some banner in the future and before you go and summon for this guy. I think Int Goku Black is overrated, but at the very least, if you summon for him, I have never had a problem finding an Int Goku Black friend. People run that team all the time. They love that. The Time Traveler team is very good. You know, it's very nice to run. So I definitely would not recommend going for Super Buu. AGL Metal Cooler is really good if you guys want to go for him, sure, even though he, you know, it's hard to find him as well. Int Goku Black, you find all over the place. People run him to death. And then obviously Gogeta and Broly, though, I feel are the true cards Global Dokkan players should be looking at if they want to summon for banners coming on the horizon. So thanks guys for watching. Again, I think the Buu Piccolo transformation is the strongest, but it's also the hardest one to get out. And I will catch y'all in the next one. And again, one final word, don't summon.